It's interesting, as you walk the floor here, there are robots, there's drones. What you don't see is the data that is informing all of the robotics and the artificial intelligence. Tell me about the project that you've overseen, the Swarm project at Toyota, how that started and how it's evolved.
Our customers, and this is now news, are living in exponential times. They are having explosive change coming to their whole supply chain. And that's where we, from Toyota Material Handling, have a focus onto. We're seeing that there are more SKUs coming on. There is e-commerce that is bringing 24/7 needs into it. Customers are getting very impatient. They want to have the product next day. So on the one side, there is an explosive demand or change in demand. On the opposite side, there are less and less people who are willing to work in this environment and work as forklift truck drivers or work in an order picking zone or transport material. So customers are sitting there, and for them it's getting more and more of a boondoggle. They don't know how to get out of it. So what we have been building is a concept that should help them. And it starts with a very simple scan of a warehouse, of an existing situation. So we come to see our customers in Spain in the future and say, show me your warehouse. We're scanning your warehouse. We're building a full digital twin, starting with two-dimensional, but then use bonsai technology to build in a three-dimensional scan. Take the software of the truck, put it into this environment, let it learn there, let it learn where to drive, where not to drive, how to respect pedestrians, how to pick up material, how to deliver material, all these things, and practice in a safe environment.
We spoke a little earlier about phone calls that you might get from customers. You were talking about predictive maintenance and how AI helps with that. Tell me the story you told me about those phone calls.
You know, we have a number of cases with customers that when you have my type of job, you're used to get a phone call from a very angry customer where the machine has just broken down. They have 50,000 liters of milk that, you know, that's very short shelf life, and the machine is broken and they can't do anything. So with predictive maintenance through AI and so, it's a lot easier because we will call them 4 weeks before and tell them that, you know, there is something that might break soon. So we will come in 2 weeks and fix it. So we will not have that very unpleasant phone conversations 4 seconds after a big failure has happened.
Throughout the book, there are conversations about conserving energy, saving water. I wonder if you could say a little bit about AI for good.
Absolutely. With Osram, we're showing how light and artificial intelligence can enable greenhouses in terms of optimization of using less chemicals and fertilizers, less water, but still be able to have very nutritious and very healthy, whether it's lettuce or whatever it is that you're growing, be in control of that environment where that engine watches the entire operation and optimizes it for you.
Microsoft is, of course, thought of as a software company, but it is also a manufacturing company as well.
Indeed.
Where is Microsoft in its AI journey within manufacturing? Maybe talk a little bit about Microsoft as a manufacturer.
We as a manufacturer, one, we're a relatively sizable manufacturer, over 40,000 SKUs shipped to over 100 countries, so it's a sizable operation. We are what we call at a predictive phase, so we get a lot of predictions, not only from our assets in terms of calibration, tuning, etc., but also from our supply chain, where we can follow up any SKU, where it sits in a container, what is the container, who's carrying it, a ship, a railroad, a truck, route, driver, insurer. It's extremely connected and visible. And then we can predict a weather system coming in and its impact on it, or a strike happening somewhere, an impact on it. We can reroute, reinsure. It's just a fascinating AI-enabled environment. Now we're moving to a cognitive phase where we think artificial intelligence will be able to make 30 to 40% of decisions for us. So we unleash leadership capacity. They manage by exceptions perhaps, but do not do much firefighting, and they focus on the strategic issues to move the company to the next level.